Yo, Kpaceguy is here, and I'm back in the vehicle. I decided that I'm gonna make a video in the car again because I'm headed to Cincinnati right now because I'm gonna repair my receiver that I have in the back seat right now. My Yamaha had fried on me and will not power on. If you haven't seen that video, there was a video a couple weeks ago explaining what happened to it. But in that video, I discussed that I'm gonna go get it repaired, and I also made a video saying that I'm gonna get a new Avery receiver as well. And I think I'm gonna go do that. So I'm headed to Cincinnati right now. I'm about halfway there, headed to the nearest repair center, which is in Cincinnati. I'm in Kentucky, I live in Frankfort. It's about an hour and a half drive if you go to speed limit. So I'm headed there, so I decided that I'm gonna make this video about the new Avery receiver and what I'm getting. I've narrowed it down. I was looking at Anthem, I was looking at Yamaha, Pioneer, not Onkyo. I just don't trust their calibration. I had Marantz and Denon. I had those receiver brands in my lineup. So I want to go ahead and talk about how I go about choosing receivers to help you guys choose receivers in your future in case you want a new one or you run into problems with yours, or maybe you're getting started with an Avery receiver. How I choose to go through Avery receivers is, first off, just go and find everything that does what you need. If you need Wi-Fi, Bluetooth connectivity, Spotify Connect, you need HDMI 2.2, 4K pass-through, go ahead and make a list of everything that you need. I still write my stuff out. I make a list on Word or something, or my notes section of my phone, and I go ahead and write down everything I need, and then go find receivers that do what I needed to do. Once I do that, I'll go back and I'll read reviews. There's tons of reviews and videos on Avery receiver products all over the internet. So you can find forums and things like that of people who already have the product, and they can tell you and show you pictures about the receiver. So I go through and I look at all the receivers that do what I needed to do. If I need 9.2 channels, 11.2 channels, I'm running a 7.1, what have you. Find all the receivers that do what you needed to do, make a list of them, and then start reading reviews and seeing what the problems are, what the good things are, what kind of sound they have, how much power they have, this, that, and the other. And then start crossing off receivers that you're like, nope, don't want that one, this one's not as good as that one, so I'm crossing this off, and etc. So what I did was I went through and read the reviews and looked at the price point of what they do and what I need and what they do that I don't need, and I started crossing it off. And the receivers that I have narrowed it down to is Marantz 7012 or 8012 and Yamaha 3070 or 2070. Now, the reason why I have two of each model is because I think the only two differences between those models from the one, the lower one of the each model, is I think one's 9.2 channels and one's 11.2. But they both give you 11.2 channels of processing. And you guys know that I have amps, external amplification, and I run my front speakers off of external amplifiers. So I don't need a full 11.2 channels from the receiver. I'm not gonna use them. So it's almost a waste of money to go and pay $400 or $500 more dollars for that extra two channels I'm not gonna use. So I have both models listed so I can see if there's anything else that makes them different other than the two channels, and I'm pretty sure that it doesn't. So that's something to think about when you're looking at receivers, is do I need the full 11.2 channels, or do I have external amplification? Do I want external amplification? Next, when I look at receivers, like what I'm doing right now, is the reason why I can't decide between the 8012, 7012, or the Yamaha 3070 or 2070 has to do with calibration, sound quality, things like that. It's not about power. When you guys look at receivers, don't look at the power rating of that speaker. I mean, of that, the amplification. Don't look at that. Look at the ohms, as in the impedance. If it's 2 ohms, 4 ohms, 6 ohms, 8 ohms. Most receivers nowadays will allow you to go down to 4 ohms, but most speakers that you have won't go that low unless you have some really high quality speakers that ask for that much power. But usually you're going to have 8 ohms, 6 ohms. My speakers are 8 ohms. Look at receivers for ohms, look at sound quality, look at the features that it has, and then the price point. Don't worry about watts per channel, because the rating on watts per channel is at two channels driven. And most people who get Avery receivers aren't getting them for two channel. I mean, you can run them in two channel, of course, but usually people who run their Avery receivers in two channels have external amplification. And why do they have that? It's because they lie sort of kind of about watts per channel. I don't want to say they lie, But they don't give you a rating at all channels driven. They give you the rating at two channels driven at a certain ohm, at a certain watt per meter. So, and then a certain total harmonic distortion, THD. The lower the percentage, the better the distortion is down. So, don't worry about wattage necessarily. Worry about future specs as far as what it can do, Wi-Fi connectivity, 4K pass-through, how efficient it is as far as standby off time, if it's not eating so much power when it's off, and things like that when you decide a receiver. Don't look and say, oh, this receiver right here is, 150 watts, but the other receiver is only giving me 80, I should go for the 150. It's really not going to matter. You really should run external amplification anyway, and I'll make a video about that coming up. My 7 reasons why video is going to be 7 reasons why you should have external amplification. I think that'd be a good video, so stay tuned for that. But worry about specs and how it sounds. So between the Yamaha and the Marantz, I love my Yamaha because of the fact that I could calibrate it the way that I wanted to. In the settings, I have 3 presets, which is like, I think with flat, through, and I'm not sure what the last one was, but they're like different presets if you want all speakers playing a flat frequency, or if you wanted to play it at how YPOW wants you to use it, that's the calibration system, or something else, I forgot what it was. But the fact that I can go and make a manual equalization if I wanted to, and I can go and crank up individual hertz for individual speakers, and I like that. It allowed me to crank up, I like to crank up 20 hertz on the subwoofers. I just love low notes, and the lower it gets, the harder it is to hear, so I like to bump that up a little bit. But it allowed you to do that to all speakers. You can change every speaker that you have in the configuration the way that you wanted it to, and still keep the preset that you have when you ran the calibration. So if I ran YPOW and then saved it as my thing, I can still go in and bump frequencies and things without changing room compensation, without changing distance, without changing level, things like that. I can keep all that the same, but still go in and change individual hertz. And I like that. In the Marantz, it runs Odyssey, just like Denon does, and Onkyo used to. And I like Odyssey for how in-depth their calibration is, which is a big factor as to why I chose a Marantz in the past. I like the calibration system that they do. The only thing about the Yamaha that I don't like over the Marantz is the Marantz is much, much, much better for music. When you put the Yamaha in pure direct and then you turn off all signal processing and all the electricity inside, you run a pure signal, it sounds really, really good. But when you listen to music just for fun, 9 channels or so or whatever, it doesn't sound, the bass does not sound very good. It sounds off. It just sounds really off. But when I ran my Marantz in 9 channels, it didn't sound bad at all. It was really, really good for music, and I like music, so it's a very important decision to make. Although the Marantz doesn't have a lot of power, it's not like in your face like Yamaha is and Pioneer. Pioneer is very warm and electrifying, and it's vivid, and I like that about the Pioneer. But it was the most expensive out of all of them, I think, minus the Marantz. And I'm not really sure if I like MCACC. I think that's my least favorite calibration out of the 3 that I've named. But with the Marantz, it sounds so crisp, clear. It sounds good for music and movies. That's a big thing. People don't want multiple sound systems or different things to switch to when listening to different content. Marantz can do it all, and I like Marantz. I like Odyssey. But with Odyssey, as I was doing reviews on Marantz, I ran across the fact that Odyssey now, Multi-EQ XD 32, it has a new app. I don't know if you guys have used it. I haven't personally seen it yet, but I've read about it. They have an app just like every other brand has now, where you can go and equalize your sound via an app on your smartphone, iPad, or whatever you have. And I like that. That's key. So I'm kind of leaning more towards Marantz. Marantz is maybe $400 to $500 more. Actually, it might almost be $1,000 more than the lowest Yamaha that I've found. I found a really good deal on a Yamaha, and I haven't really found a really good deal on Marantz, but it's much pricier than the Yamaha, but I think you're getting more. They both will run 11.2 out of the box, I believe. Maybe not the Yamaha, but the Marantz should run 11.2 out of the box. And I don't know, it's just a good receiver. It's smaller than the Yamaha. It doesn't look as good as the Yamaha, in my opinion, but it's Marantz. You know, it's a name you can trust. So that's the contemplation that I'm going through right now. So I'm just saving up a little bit more money, because I think I might just go ahead and get the Marantz and just be happy with that. I think I'm gonna keep the receiver that I have in the back, my Yamaha RX-A3060. I'm gonna fix that up and keep it, because I do have my old sound system, which is a Fluon 7.0 channels that I have. I still have that. I'm gonna use that when I move as a bedroom home theater, because the theater that I have now is gonna be in the living room, because it's gonna be a bigger space. And I still have the Fluon Signature Series, and I'm gonna use the Yamaha on that, so I still have music and movies in the bedroom, and then in the living room I have sound there too. But it was coming to my mind, though, if I'm gonna just repair the Yamaha, maybe I'll still go ahead and get the Emotiva amp that I was gonna get. If you guys haven't seen that video, I asked you guys to help me pick an external amplifier to replace my Emotiva Bass X-A300, which only is 150 watts per channel, two channels driven. It's a two channel amp, so I wanna upgrade that to 7 and run all my speakers off of the amp, and then run my Atmos on the receiver. I want to do that still. It's going to take me a little bit longer now if I get a new receiver, but maybe I won't get a new receiver. I'm not sure. I think I might get a new receiver because things are starting to change now. Marantz runs Oral 3D out of the box now. You used to have to pay $200 for it, but now they give it to you for free. And I think that'd be really cool to have, because I would like to compare that with DTS:X and Atmos. I think that'd be a really good video, because I know a lot of people have videos of Oral 3D on their channels, but not really a comparison of which one's better and what it does and why you should maybe pick 3D over Atmos and DTS:X. So I think that would be really cool to have. So I'm really leaning towards the Marantz, but feel free to leave me a comment and things like that. Give me your opinion of which one you would get, or which one you like better. If you have one or have heard one, let me know which one you guys like. But right now, it's like 55% Marantz, 45% Yamaha. I just love Yamaha. I like the power, the sound, the look of the receiver, the features, and the tweaking that I could do. But I might have to download this app just to see what the app does, and maybe that will decide for me. But stay tuned for that. Gonna have my receiver fixed. I'm not sure if I can get it fixed and get it right back out, or if I have to wait on it and have them send it to me, or come back up to get it. I'm not sure, but it will be fixed today, and we'll have to see when I get it back. I'm about to graduate on Saturday, so I'm going to pick up some grandparents now from Cincinnati anyway. So I'm gonna go see them, have a good time. I decided to bring my receiver while I'm up here. So stay tuned for that. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe on this video. On all the videos that you've seen, like, comment, subscribe on everything. I know you guys out there are enjoying it. I'm enjoying making videos for you. So stay tuned. Don't miss anything. Good things are still happening here on this channel. And so I'm gonna get my eyes back on the road. So stop distracting me. Stop distracting me, guys. Kpaceguy out.